Advance Wars is a game rated E10+ by the ESRB. Advance Wars. Okay, then. I should probably explain. I mean, I figured it'd probably be for the best to have a secondary series of two air alongside Earthbound Beginnings. Something that doesn't have too much story by way of contrast. I mean, don't get me wrong, I know for a fact this has its fair share of story, and I have nothing against story, but just for something different. But anyway, enough of that. I mean, the battlefield calls. Advance Wars. Keep that to your name. Okay, so rather than entering a name, I'm going to just enter a rank. So, let's see. How about okay, so the word colonel is too long. Oh well. Simple solution. There. I mean, I figured it would probably work, because I assume that, what's-her-name is my superior officer in this game, so. So I'm hoping that this would be a rank in between hers and the three on the and the three in the title screen. Assuming they're sergeants or lieutenants, that is. But if I'm wrong, this will make for an interesting choice. Hopefully making it all capitals will make it easy to separate this from any dialogue that may be scripted and is this correct? I guess it is close enough. It's nice to meet you, Colonel. I'm now. I'm a commanding officer in the Shasar Army. Is this your first time playing? Or Well, I mean, yes, but it's, admittedly, you don't become, admittedly, if I were an actual colonel, this would not be my first battle. Otherwise, it wouldn't go over so well. Not to mention I'd be court-martialed. No wait, just outright arrested for impersonating an officer. But I'll reluctantly say yes, because this is a sort of blind playthrough.
Very well. Let me explain a few things briefly. There are several different modes of gameplay. The first mode is for multiplayer battle on one Game Boy Advance. To play Advance Wars on multiple systems, link up with friends and try the link mode. Then there's field training. If you're playing for the first time, you should start with field training. Would you choose field training on the mode select menu, please? In field training, I can instruct you on the game controls and overall battle strategy. Once in field training, please complete the missions in order, from top to bottom. The first lesson is on troop orders. Start here.
Well, here goes nothing.
Basic troop movement and attack controls are explained here. Troop orders. First, let me brief you on the situation. We're in this large nation here, Orange Star. Terrible delivery on that line. Yeah, it should have made more room between Advent and well. The country to the east is Blue Moon. The two countries have been bitter rivals for years. Border skirmishes have died down recently, until that madman, Olaf. Oh, excuse me, I read up. The Blue Moon commanding officer, Olaf, took the order to the invasion of Orange Saw. Now held by Blue Moon forces. Candidate Colonel, you have been given a mission. You are to drive Olaf from Alara and secure it for Orange Star. I will be your support. Let's move out.
Okay, first day on the battlefield. Hopefully, quoting her is her line. Hopefully, quoting the general's lines. comes through on the recording. Because I've noticed that with Earthbound Beginnings, sometimes it hasn't. The alarm region is quite remote. That's why Olaf hasn't deployed any troops to the area. You yourself have two infantry units under your command. These point units are yours. These three units of the enemy, they belong to the Blue Moon Army. Successfully. Well, that's issue to notice. The cursor is used to give commands. The D-pad moves the cursor. Yeah, I'm not gonna call it it's plus control pad or the narration. D-pad is what I'll use instead, and you should know what I mean. Anyway. First, let's command this infantry unit. Can you please hurt us on the infantry unit, please? Okay, so cursor is on there. Now, do I press A or B? Okay, so that's, I guess, a range for either attack or travel. Yeah, should have known. But I just wanted to see if anything would happen if I deliberately did something in the wrong order. Or assumed wrong order, I should say.
The action you just completed it is called selecting. You'll see this term often, so do your best to remember it. When you select a unit, the area around it will become highlighted. This area represents the selected unit's range of movement. First, let's approach the enemy with this unit. By moving the unit into this space, move the cursor here and press the A button. After a unit moves, this menu will appear. Select wait and then press the A button to confirm the command. The unit's color changed, right? This indicates that the unit can't receive any more orders this turn. Don't worry, they'll be able to use it again on your next turn. Now, let's use the same controls to move this infantry unit. Move as close as possible to the enemy.
Okay, I think I get the idea now. But I guess I should probably, for the sake of seeing this through, do all of this.
Units have finished their movements for this turn. When you finish giving orders to your units, you must end your turn. Press the A button on empty spaces, play the map menu.
F. Orange Star Army units have been moved into the Alara region. Nah, that's a bit too high. It should probably be a bit deeper. Ah, they won't last long. Yeah, that's a bit better. My troops will have the Omega Shot work on them. Famous last words. It looks like along with that, we notice our arrival. You think the drinking is our thing this way? Stay calm. Proceed. If we proceed, your caution will be fine. Now it's time to order this infantry unit to fire all the enemy. Looks like its unit. Infantry units must be next to the enemy to fire on them. Move your unit here. Can you see the fire command button on the menu? Please select this command. Don't have to tell me twice. This is the cursor you will use to select the enemy unit to attack. There's only one unit you can engage now, so press escape and fire. Goodbye. You scored damage on the enemy. Do you see the numbers on the units? This indicates the unit's health points, I mean hit points. Units begin with 10 hit points, but as they take damage in battle, their hit points will decrease. When a unit reaches 0 hit points, it will vanish from the screen, because there's no more left. Notice that your unit has more hit points than the enemy unit. This is because the unit that attacks first generally has the advantage. Waiting to be attacked is not a good strategy. You should pick your battles and always fire first. If you fire on this unit again, you should defeat it. Now order your other... now order your remaining infantry unit to hit the enemy. And goodbye. Congratulations. There's only one enemy left to deal with. If you stick to your battle plan, you can finish it off. You can finish it off too. Select it from the menu and continue on your next turn.
What are those fools doing? If I were in the field, they wouldn't be suffering such humiliation. Curse Orange Star Army. I will defeat it. I will.
And now you're out in the open. Terrible strategy, because you just walked into my trap. Which, admittedly, is all pre-planned by Nell.
It's not a turn again. You have a 2-1 advantage. This battle is yours to win. But wait a minute. This unit took damage in the last battle, didn't it? You need to lose some of their firepower with them. So it's better to fire on the enemy, even on damaged units. ahead and order your undamaged units. The A button is used to select units and issue commands. If you make a mistake and want to change orders, use the B button. It's key that you remember this. Now that the enemy unit is damaged, this infantry unit can finish it and fire on it. All of the enemy units. Your mission is a success. Keep up the good work.
What? Inconceivable! That land was mine! How did they lose it so easily? Next time, victory will be mine!
Congratulations, Colonel. You won. Now, you will see the rank that your strategy has earned you. Speed is based on how quickly you run, while power is based on how you concentrate your attacks and overcame the enemy. Technique is based on how many of your own troops were lost. You learn a rank for each map you clear. You can compare your scores to your friends. Good luck on your next campaign. Save your time data. Yes. Save complete.
So how many of these are there anyway? I think I get the idea. I consider this part as the A story, so I guess I have to do it all. Although I'm already a good 20 minutes in. Well, may as well get it over with.
Inspire the Marines. Their HQ is in another area, so we believe it's the covert attack. A covert attack that sounds like something Olaf would try. Your goal is to take out these units. You've been giving them 4 infantry units to carry out the operation. Let's go. The enemy has deployed some mechanized infantry units. This could be trouble. Mechs have more firepower than your standard infantry do. You won't be able to defeat mechs in direct combat. So you'll have to use terrain to give yourself some defensive cover. I'll explain about terrain features as we go. Select this infantry unit, please. Let's do this infantry unit to fire. Excellent. Okay, select this infantry unit next, please. Not clear, please select this infantry unit. Yeah, this one. You notice anything different? Up to now, the highlight tape movement area for the infantry was 2 spaces.
Moving will cost double here. This means your movement rate will be half of that in the plane. Do you think that means you should avoid the mountains? That would be a very serious tactical error. Mountains offer advantages that compensate for the movement cost. You'll understand once you fire on the enemy. Go ahead and engage the enemy in fire. The hit points of the two infantry units you used to attack. Last unit took damage than the first unit, didn't it? This is because of another terrain feature called defense cover. You attack the enemy from the mountains, right? Defensive cover for the mountains in December here. The defensive cover on the plains is a 1. The higher the defensive cover rating is, the less damage you'll take. Is that clear? Good. I mean, you were quick setting. Go ahead, fire on the remaining infantry units. Select in for your finish. Not the best solution, but whatever. Actually, could I move here? Nope. Unfortunately, you have to stand out in the open and attack. Well, get rid of this guy. Or this batch of guys, I should say. Now, should be able to get into the other mountain at least. And attack the other guy. And I'll just so, you've spotted my troops, haven't you? That's pretty good. But this time, things will be different. You'll learn what it means to face mech units. I'll just keep watch from back here. No need for me to actually be in the field. I'm still in charge, though. Oh, how cocky. And yes, I know I was in a bad spot, but at least I have some cover. I'll get you.
Is really packed a punch, I think.
If you know, what if you'll notice? One infantry unit took less damage than the other. Maybe I should have had that guy stay behind.
Superior defense cover, remembering that this is vital. You should also keep in mind that movement costs differs between units. For example, mechs and infantry units have different movement types. So, their respective movement costs sit in the mount per 2 to 1. When you need to, like, just place a cursor on a space and press the R button. This works for terrain features as well as for all unit types. So, for intel on the move, save cost, etc., remember the R button. Well, I'll leave the S's battle to you. They may have mech units, but you have superior numbers. Focus on your friend, use your power and victory, you will be yours.
What does the L button do? Oh, good. First things first. Actually, which one has more? Unfortunately, I want to take this guy out, so that means I guess I'll put the stronger one in the forest or in the woods. Well, that didn't work. Hoping to win without losing a single unit. Perhaps I should have merged them. Okay, so can't move around that guy. This is gonna take longer than I thought. What's the matter, cowards?
Oh, one more thing. If at any point during battle there's a need to stop, there is a way to save. Maybe we'll prevent you from having to start the same mission over again. Please go over to the map menu now. Place the cursor on an empty space and press the A button. There's a save point. This will allow you to save the area of progress during battle. If you need to take a break from the mission, I'll let you decide whether or not to save at this point. Maybe just a little more work here. You should defeat Olaf. Don't let your guard down though. Good luck and move out. Eh, why not? Attack. Take that. Now, which one of you shall get the honor of taking out this guy? You know what? I'll let the smaller unit have this one. It's really we're on a covert operation. Not operating. Thanks for your planning, our troops took minimal damage. What about the unit that is completely gone? Well, no matter. At the end of the game when I'm rich, I'll probably just build a statue.
put it in a park. In honor of the first unit to fall. Oh well.
Another failure! After all my careful planning, another botched mission. Next time I will prevail!
Victorious.